Right, well, I played the game. Well, okay. What's happened is I was playing and I wanted to plug my tablet into the back into the into what is it called again? The socket, plug socket. And moving the plug socket slightly caused my entire computer to shut down unexpectedly. And that has caused subsequently caused my sorry, I'm just gonna cough here. That has caused my video that I was recording to be lost forever and ever into the ether of random access memory nothingness. So, what's the plan? Okay, I was just going to tell you. So, I decided right from the start that I wanted to go find a basilisk straight away. And I went down up the left side, fought a bunch of rats. I got really annoyed at how many rats I came across. I had to escape from two knights, and then I used a rappel. I got into the cave, and in the cave, I used rappel before the knights. In the cave, I got into the lava. I fought one juggernaut. I had to use some twists, blasts, regen, and I used a death on him at the end. And I'm currently now on. Let's just take a look. I think I'm basically on 4,920 odd HP, so that was unexpected. I wasn't really planning on that, but it's not a bad thing, eh? Okay. Come on. Hurry up. Okay. Oops. Just hit my screen. Yeah, 4,924. Oh, yeah, that's what I was gonna do. See, I wanted to install Evernote on my tablet because if I'm farming, I may as well be doing something productive as I'm farming. And because I've got so much health now, all I have to do is just hold down X. So what I'm going to do on my tablet is install Evernote so I can make notes while I'm actually looking at that. Evernote. No internet connection. Brilliant. Could have told me that before. Evernote, stay organized. I've just seen the message from. Okay, rid of that. It's downloading. Ah, but I might not have all the bullet point stuff and formatting. Ah, it doesn't matter. I'll figure it out. So, after I defeat the basilisk, what was my plan? Okay. Oh shit. I forgot. I'm just gonna do this. There we go. It's installing, hopefully. It will give me all the formatting options I desire. Okay. It's loading email or username. What was this thing? The bomb fragment thing. Okay. Bomb fragment at Gmail. Continue. Password. Well, let's see if I can remember the password. Yeah, I can't select. Okay. I hope it's this password. Login error, invalid password. Okay. Is it this password? Invalid password. Do you reckon it would be? I think it would be wise if I'm not saying anything to just speed up this entire process of farming. So I'm literally holding down just one. Okay, so it's not. It doesn't seem to be this password. Can you tell me if I forgot my password already? Is it this password? No, it's not this password. How many passwords do I have? Let's try my most bog standard password that I use. Okay, I'll have to reset the password. Ugh, for Pete's sake. Or log in with. Oh no, I've already reset the password, haven't I? Okay, do I have Gmail here? Where's Gmail? Here we go. I need to add an account. Add an account. How do I add an account? I have to go into settings. This is thrilling conversation, by the way. Accounts. Here we go. Google. No, I need to add an account. Add. Existing. I'm just going to run away now. All this effort. Password. Alright, more of the same. So now I've got this on here. Can I log in? Let's just move Evernote to everything else. Can I log in with Google? Continue with Google. Will it let me? No wonder. Lovely, I'm in. Okay, so. Okay, so this is quite. This note taking thing is quite bog standard, I'd say. Hopefully it will be. Edit note, here we go. Oh. Oh, what is it? Why is this superscript? Win has turned into superscript in my tablet. Okay, below defeat Basilisk. What are the other targets? Discover final spell. This is another short-term one. And this will be tied to explore, really. Okay, my quick notes. How do I add? Oh, I don't think I can add. Let's get rid of the keyboard. Yeah, this note taking up isn't particularly good. Oh, here we go, formatting options. Ah, nice, okay, I found him. Okay, it's a bit messy, but. Alright, so I need. What do I want to do? Basically, stock up on spells. What else do we need to do? What else? Stock up on spells. Oh yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. This is just gonna be. This whole session is gonna be dedicated to the Basilisk. So I need to fight. Stock up on spells. I'm going to do individual spells that I need. So I need healing. Often done by kind of category slash individual spell. Healing. Damaging. Need death. And I'm going to need more lava walk because I used them all. Lava walk. Probably by virtue of getting lava walk, I'll be getting hollowed more health, which is, you know, unavoidable at this point. Unless the game decides I'm not learning anything anymore by fighting the guys. I should get some Shakespeare up and just read. Get some audiobook stuff going. Okay, if I say I'm done with this, I can probably sync it and show you. Your changes are not saved. Okay, how do I save the changes? Save. But is this going to mess the formatting up on my Windows one? Yeah. Why is the formatting all bloody topsy-turvy? We'll see when it syncs. I've only got 10 recovers and I've been here ages. Alright, I'm just going to run now. I'll run straight. No. Here we go. Yeah, it's just messed up all my formatting. Fine, let's get rid of these bullet points. Oops. Yeah, you sync all your stuff across the entire, you know, plethora of gadgets that you have. Well, they don't sync all that well, do they? We didn't tell you about that, did we? I could probably just fight skeletons now, because they can't kill me, I don't think. Unless they do a damage that scales with the amount of health that you have, which could be pretty cool, but I doubt that's something the creator would have done. So I think I'm going to get to 20 recovers, and then I'm going to go and farm the Chimera a bit more. Because I need the damaging spells. Without them, I am useless. Oh, crap. Something I could do. Can I edit YouTube videos from my YouTube app? I'm signed in into the correct thing. My channel. Is there like a video editor? I reckon there isn't. No. No. I can't do anything. Yeah, this tablet is quite old. It's a really nice tablet. It's got like a really nice screen. The speakers are very good. But unfortunately, it's running an old version of Android. And I don't know what exactly is wrong with this, but it freezes kind of frequently. Especially YouTube playback. It's quite terrible. About device. It's a GTN8010. Let's have a look. GTN8010. To be fair, browsing is really smooth. And most other apps are actually quite good. Just video playback is pretty pants. GSM Arena. Let's have a look. Full tablet specifications. Yeah, it's a really nice one. The camera's pants, apparently, but who uses cameras on a tablet? 2 GB of RAM, 7,000 mAh battery. That means that the battery on my tablet needs to be replaced because it does not last very long. Holy crap, it does it not last very long. Android 4.0.3. And the CPU is a quad core 1.4. Yeah. Yeah, that's not ideal, is it? It cost €350 back in the day. Yes, it is. Tethering hotspot. How do you know if... How... Hello, do you know how long the battery would last on this while using the GPS? Maybe that's what I need to do, just turn off GPS. Don't know why it's on. What's the point in it? It's a tablet. Also, do you know if it has a magnetometer? Okay. How many do I have? 15 now. Making your meeting rooms wireless. This is 2012, so this tablet is 6 years old now. No, 5.5 years old. That's fair enough. It was a very good tablet when we first got it. Samsung TouchWiz UI. Okay, let's just escape now. There we go. It's a rat. Oh no. Oh no. I don't think I should be here at this point, by the way. I mean, I don't think I should be anywhere near the starting area. Because farming these spells, like... If we take a look. With extract, it's up to 30%, right? So... It's up to 30% that I get heal, I imagine. And then it's slightly more for regenerate, and slightly less for regenerate, slightly less for recover. So I should be finding enemies that are the other way around. For which recover is the top one, and other more useful spells than heal and regen are available. That's my impression anyway. Okay, so I don't know what there is to do with this, what I could do with this tablet to make it faster. Let's have a look also at the current Android version. 4.1.2. It's a jelly bean, okay. Rat, rat, tat, tat. Okay. Yeah, YouTube on this tablet just slows to a crawl sometimes. Okay. Yes, with stereo speakers, yes. Back when the first iPad was released. What was this? 2009, 2010? I'm not sure, but basically when it was first released, I really don't understand the point of a tablet. To this day, I reckon tablets, aside from watching a film maybe, or just having video watching, it's good. Anything else, it's kind of crap. That's my impression anyway. That's my opinion. Because every time, I remember when I was at university, a bunch of people had, instead of buying a laptop, so at university I had my laptop that I had from school. I went to a posh school, so, well, for A-levels I went to a posh school. And they kind of sold laptops, and like all the kids had, if they wanted to buy a laptop through the school, which obviously all the MacBook users, the really expensive £3,000 Facebook machines, they didn't have to, but generally, loads of people had the school machines, which were built by some sort of tiny company in Nottinghamshire. I had that first year university, which was a small, I think, called a netbook, wasn't it? Back in the day. An 11-inch or 12-inch screen computer. And then when I went to Russia, I bought myself a pretty beefy was a gaming laptop. It wasn't the best gaming laptop. This was at a time where you didn't have all the fancy. Okay, I've got 21 recovers after this, so I'm gonna head off. You didn't have the fancy, you didn't have the fancy. What am I trying to say? You know, the desktop grade graphics cards in the laptops. Anyway, it was a Lenovo. Lenovo Y580, and it was fantastic. I loved it. But people at university had tablets with the kind of fold-out screens, the fold-out keyboards, sorry, like the USB ones. And they just looked really horrible. Like, horrible. Not as in they looked tacky or they looked cheap. They looked horrible to type on. Such an uncomfortable typing experience, I would have assumed, judging by the fact that the majority of people who had those had that kind of gear, they just bought a cheap laptop, decidedly. Decidedly a better option. Oh, another good thing about this tablet is the pen, the drawing capabilities. I use it actually for doodling and for just designing stuff. I say designing stuff as if it's doing, I'm doing something really fancy and important. No, just for mucking about, basically. It didn't have the best contrast ratio. iPad 2 had a better one. It was the same as the original iPad. Redesigned S Pen. Let's look at the user opinions and reviews, see what people have said about it. Dear sir, my Galaxy Note 10.1 almost 5 years working good, but suddenly is not working. What is the reason? Please help me, sir. I am waiting for your reply. Thanks. That was from Kumar on the 16th of June, 2017. How to open my tab GTN 8000 and replace the battery. I think Google is your friend, MD Abid. I have Samsung Galaxy Note 10.1, which, as in, you know, on a broomstick, which I use since 9 months with good condition, but now he have charge problem. He take charging in 1 hour, 5%, spelled correctly. But that time, remove charge notes, now showing low battery. Kindly tell what is the problem. I am going to use a heel or two. I've got plenty to spare. A great device by Samsung. I've been using N8000 since 4 years. Never, this guy's German. Never had a problem with this. Tried some other brands, but nothing can beat this one. Only con is there. This is a little heavy. Is it a little heavy? I suppose. Tried some other brands. Oh yeah, a little heavy. But Note 8000 is the best. Good camera, good graphics, good display, good RAM. Everything is great. Why am I not escaping? What are you doing, fairy? What are you doing to me? Alright. There we go. Alright, I'm done. I don't need to go there anymore. I'm gonna go to the scouter and get some explores. Not explores. It's not what I wanted. I wanted some analyzers. You can try using Chromecast for connecting N8000 to your TV. Please, can anyone help to explain the major difference between this device and the smaller Note 2, apart from the size? I surely need one of the two things. Okay. Crap. Yeah, I bought a really good application on Android called FPSC. This was a while ago. I think it cost me about £4. And it's a PlayStation 1 emulator. It's really good. It is really good. I I've got no disc, no games installed. But it's. I think the first game I played on it was. All these games, by the way, I have purchased so many times. There's an argument to be had against pirating and all that kind of stuff, which emulation technically is, because you're not using the original discs. And you're not supposed to copy it from a disc to an ISO file and so on. But every single game that I have an emulation, so I had, originally when I played got the application for my phone, I had Final Fantasy VIII, obviously. I had, what's the other one? I got Gran Turismo, verify your email. Gran Turismo, the car racing one. I bought a number of them. Well, not I bought, I got a number of them. I'm just gonna run from this guy, he's annoying. Another one I tried, but turns out I am horrible at it, is Micro Machines. I remember we had that game. There's so many games that I had when I was a kid. And I just remember playing them for hours and hours and hours on end. That's my memory, at least, so obviously that could be lying to me. But when I played them as an adult, I really suck at them. And I must have been even worse back in the day. Oh, why are you... I must have been even worse back in the day. Let's go further. Scouter. That's another thing that's kind of... It's been on my mind recently, is that looking back on certain things, I remember it as having played it for hours and hours and hours on end. Things such as, okay, take Final Fantasy VIII. In my mind, I have played through that game about 25 times. But when I think about it, 25 times would have meant that I would have had to play it once a year. So that number is probably closer to maybe 10 that I've played through and actually completed it. So let me think. The first time I played it with my older brother. Well, I didn't play it, I was watching him play it. And he got to Ultimetius Castle. School was level, I think, 40, and the rest of the characters were level 10. Or were low level, but he had no magic whatsoever, and he wasn't able to defeat her. So that was probably the first playthrough, obviously, where it wasn't completed. And we didn't really understand farming or anything then, so we just played the game again. And the next time, the next time was actually an incredible playthrough, and will stick with me forever. I've spoken about it before. We had several really interesting moments. This would have been the playthrough where in which I was on calculator duty. I've spoken about this before, where we found out online. We didn't know about we probably used scan, actually. We would have used scan to find out the enemy's HP, and then we would have we'd use scan to find out the HP, and then I would have just been on calculator duty taking away all the damage that we did. And at that point, we definitely did not have Lionheart, so it would have been, or Wishing Star would have been fairly easy to calculate the damage. Meteor's probably the hardest one back then. But that happened in that playthrough. What else would have happened in that playthrough? When we played, when my brother fought against Bahamut in the sort of deep sea research center on the surface, and our halfway through the fight, our TV broke, and all you could hear was the sound. The TV went completely red, and you couldn't see anything. It was an old CRT Mitsubishi TV. And it was such that you had to keep switching on and off rapidly. On, off, on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off. And then sometimes it would catch the image. That's how we got it working at the beginning. It was really old. Anyway. So that was... Yeah, that was interesting. He managed to win. He managed to defeat Bahamut using his memory and just the sound cues. It was pretty incredible. I think it probably helped that back then. Because now in the config, whenever I play Final Fantasy VIII, I always set. This guy's not giving me much magic, is he? I'm not impressed. I always set the menu or the cursor to memory as opposed to reset. I think back then we would have been on reset, so we would have been able to memorize where or remember where all the magic was, where all the commands were, and so on. But that was really fun. And finally, when we got to Ultimich's castle, I think he saved just outside Ultimich's castle or something. I think he saved it. Then he went with my dad. When my dad went to work, he was just in the car, which is something I usually did, but this time he did it. And I remember I wanted to play Final Fantasy VIII, so I played it on my own. I loaded up the game. I went to fight Ultimitia, and I fought the first her first thingy, her first version, and that was really tough for me back then. And then I fought Griever, and that was really tough back then. But you know when the sound kind of drowns out, although that's the second bit. Oh no, that's when you hear the so in terms of music, you have Premonition, then you have Maybe I'm a Lion, and the one after that, the Legendary Beast. When the Legendary Beast came on, I got shit scared, basically. I got really, really scared, and I paused I didn't even fight him. I paused the game, and then I ran downstairs to get the telephone, and I rang my dad's mobile number, spoke to my brother, and he just said, "Just play it, just play it, just try it, give it a go, and let me know what you think." And he, no, but I didn't. I waited until he got back. That's a cool memory. I really enjoy that one. I was just way too scared. That music shows you that you get serious, even though Ultimate is really easy now. Now that I've played it a few times and I'm an adult, but back then, yeah, it was a real deal. Oh. So that would have been the second time, theoretically, that I've played through it. Third time, actually, the first time, well, not I personally, but I witnessed a playthrough, but I was there. The first time, actually, we didn't even get to Ultimich's castle, because this wasn't the middle brother, this was the oldest brother. He was playing the game first, because he's, oldest, he had control. He got to Esther, he got to the bit where you had to fly the Ragnarok into the Lunatic Pandora. And for some reason, either he misread it or he didn't understand, but he said that you had to take Rinoa or something, you had to take someone, or you have to take the party to, no, sorry, we already had Laguna in our Ragnarok, so he said you had to take Laguna to Odin's laboratory. And then so I remember we were stuck on just figuring out what the hell we're supposed to do, so we kept going to just Odin's laboratory and walking around there and not really understanding what we were supposed to do. And I think that playthrough petered out. We never finished it. And then we had the one where we didn't finish because we were too low level and not enough magic to fight Ultimitia, or not enough junctions. Next one we actually did it. And I remember my brother watched the final FMV before me, so I don't think we actually completed it then. I might have just gone to sleep or something. And then there was another time where I went out with my dad to work. My brother stayed back, and then he called and said that he's watched the final cutscene or something, and he was beaming. He was really happy. What else? Then I can't remember playing it again on my own on the PlayStation 1. I really don't recall. I definitely played it again on the PlayStation 2, so you can count that as the second time where I actually played it. So that would have been the second playthrough where I actually played as well. Because when we actually fought Ultimitia, I was playing it as well. It was a joint save, not just me watching or me on a calculator duty. I played as well, so that would have been the second time. And then I remember when we moved to our new house. And I got a new computer. My mum bought me Well, with my brother, my brother's it was my brother's idea, 'cause he knew that I loved Final Fantasy VIII so much at that point. They bought me Final Fantasy VIII for the PC. Was the PC 2000 copy, and I was, you know, crazy. I was really impressed by it. I'm just gonna extract a bit more. That'll do. I was really impressed by it, and I just loved it. It was really enjoyable. And there, I think I played through it once normally. Then I played through it a second time. Yes, I played through it once normally. Then I discovered Chocobo World. And I had Chocobo World running. But I don't know why. But either I didn't understand it. How old would I have been? I would have been 12 at that point. Yeah, I would have been 12 years old. For some reason, I didn't understand what was going on. And I didn't kind of make the connection that Chocobo World, you're just supposed to leave it. Leave it to do its own thing. And that's all you're supposed to do. See, I thought it was more along the lines of you're supposed to play it and then you're supposed to complete it and whatever that helps you or something. Then I'd play it a second time, and I remember getting Eden for the first time. So I remember we did get Eden before, but we didn't know that she can do more than she can break the 9999 limit. We never saw that before. And I remember getting Eden, junctioning it to a character, and going straight to the island next to the island close to hell, and fighting the little birds, Thrustivus, or whatever it's called. Fighting those birds. Very bot. And Eden did like 12,000 damage. And for me, for some reason, I remember it. Oh crap, is this the right way I'm going? Yeah. Okay. Let's just use regen, because it's not very good anyway. What other things? Mage. Yeah, let's see what you got. I said, I think mages are crap. I'm pretty sure they only have heal, recover, regenerate. Horse. Horses have explore. I don't have many warps anymore. I ought to get more warps as well. So I think I should fight the, what is it called? The wizard. You're a wizard, Harry. Giant. I don't have the magic to fight you, I'm afraid. But I hope you don't kill me, giant. I hope you're a friendly one. So that playthrough I had Eden was definitely either the second or the third playthrough I played on the PC. Because I think the first one I would have just sped through. I just played how I knew how to play. What's happened? Ah, my controller's buggered. There we go. Yeah, that happens sometimes. The cable's frayed at the top, but I don't think it's the cable. I think it's just the actual controller. It's happened right from the beginning. Is this guy gonna do any damage? I hope he doesn't do the fast damage. If he is, I'm just gonna run away. No, he doesn't. He's not very good at damage. Okay. So say we're on. Oh yeah. So I would have had. So we've got two on the PlayStation 1, one on the PlayStation 2. Let's say two on the PC, and then I would have had a third one. No, two on the PC, and the second time halfway through, I started installing mods. I think What I found out that you can break the damage limit, I might have done a Google search or something, and found that with the FF8 launcher on, you can get from QHIM, you can find kind of mods for it that breaks the damage limit for all characters all the time. So your maximum health can be 30 something, 3768, and 65536 is the maximum damage you can do. That was that. And then when do I need to use recover? At 3200. Great. Forgot about that. Then I remember when I went to school, when I went to rugby school, I had. That was the posh school I went to. I had installed it on my laptop. I don't think I have actually ever completed it on my laptop, however, because it was just kind of I installed it, and then I just played around with it every now and again. I don't think I ever completed it. I think I only played it whenever I had sort of free periods and I didn't have anything to do. Then I bought it for PlayStation 3. So, 2, 1, 2. An extra one, but I didn't complete it. So I wouldn't really call that a playthrough. Then on PlayStation 3, I definitely completed it once. And on my Lenovo laptop, I completed it once. Yeah, so I've under 10 times I've actually completed the game. But my mind always tells me that I've played it over 20. There's another thing. Oh, bollocks, I forgot to do the thing again. There was another thing. I've already spoken about this before, but I went through a period of time where I made loads of maps for a game called Delta Force Black Hawk Down. So it's just levels, like multiplayer maps, multiplayer levels. And in my mind, I'd made, dozens, if not about 100 maps back from the period of 2006 to 2009. In that entire period, because I was playing on a server and sending maps to the server, and they were playing my maps fairly frequently, so it was not as though I just made them and they were lost in the internet. They were actually played by people. People actually enjoyed them. But in my mind, I'd created hundreds of them. I was there for hours and hours and hours and hours after school. I came back and I wanted to just make these maps. And then, in reality, when I look back on when I've recovered, I found my old PC. Well, I found my old PC. I switched my old PC back on. Just had a look at what was on the hard drive, and funny enough, it was a Windows XP operating system butchered with a whole load of random, just random cack. Like, now I have customized the way look of Windows 10. I did the same for Windows XP back when I was a kid, and but it was absolutely butchered. It looked horrific, and it didn't really run very well. But still, I managed to save all those things that I made back in the day. And I just think my mind's lying to me. It keeps telling me that I did all these things, that I did so much more than I've got sort of evidence for. And the thing is, if I try to think of, if I try to imagine, if I try to remember other sort of creative stuff that I've done for that game, I can't picture an exact kind of multiplayer mission or something that I came up with. Only the ones that I've actually got credit for, I've got evidence for. So what it means is, either I made loads of maps that didn't sort of pass my own quality control, and I deleted them, or the memories of fabrication, and I can't trust it. It's interesting anyway. Oh. We're here for a while, aren't we? So, last 22, how many twists? 13. And he gives you twist, blast, and what? Blast? Oh, freeze. We've got 73 freezes. Okay, let's recover. Gonna let the charge bar get quite big. I wonder what he does. Maybe he does less damage if I don't damage him. Maybe he does more, perhaps. We'll see what happens. Yeah, maybe I thought also maybe by doing them in rapid succession, in quick succession, you have a greater chance of extracting or something. No, nothing of the sort. It's pretty much the same. One thing I definitely know for sure is back when I was a kid and I had the PlayStation 3, I played Call of Duty. I was one of those kids. Not one of those kids that shouted down the microphone and got really angry at it and all that kind of stuff, but I had a group of friends that we played together and I played a lot of it. I'm pretty sure playtime reached a couple of days at least. Twenty-nine blasts. How many twists? 17. I also have a game for Android called Wayward Souls. I'm just gonna turn it on now on my tablet. And it's a dungeon kind of game. Dungeon crawler, I think that's what they call it. I don't think it's going to be something the creator might like, on the grounds that it's an action type thing. I always play as the rogue, because she does swipes. Oh no, she kind of does sprints or dashes. Dashes, that's what it's called. The only kind of customization that you have of the characters is very linear, and you have to basically... You go through the dungeon, you fight enemies, and you have to get to the end of the dungeon. Getting to the end of the dungeon unlocks the next dungeon. And you repeat the dungeons are randomly generated. So some dungeons, I've noticed in my own experience, some dungeons are easier to play through than others. And you have various floors of the dungeon, so when you get to the next floor, you recover a bit of health. And that's the only really way... Oh, and you also... No, you do have sort of pickups. You can get pick up health potions, stun grenades, all this kind of random stuff. But in the menu, you do have upgrades. So by killing enemies and by picking up loot, you get gold. And with gold, you can pick up enemies. And this is a game, by the way, that it's you pay for it. So I paid... What would I have paid? I would have paid, I think, £4 again. Pretty cheap. That said, it's not that cheap considering, you know, Steam sales and so on, but... It was pretty cheap, and there are absolutely no microtransactions. That's something I adore. In any case, the upgrades. For example, upgrade sheer stinginess. Your attacks cost less energy, and you have 5 levels to the upgrade. So, first level is -5 energy cost, and it costs 50 gold to buy it. Different one, fake out. Your first dash through an enemy confuses it. Next level, 0.2 seconds of confusion. The other one is +1 points of bonus damage, +1 health when entering the next floor, and then raises your chance of doing double damage with melee attacks, so critical hits. What's this one? Upgrade low blow, extends stun duration, increases maximum health, and all classes use less energy in attacks and abilities. Yeah, and these are fairly linear. You can't really do much with them. But each hero, to be fair, has different kind of... How do I continue? Yeah, each hero has different upgrades and stuff. And how many heroes are there? So we have the warrior, who's just a big muscular bloke with a sword, I think, or with a battle axe. We have a mage, which is a woman with really low health, but kind of ranged attacks. The rogue is a woman who's really fast, has average health, really fast, and has a swipe thing. And her attacks are fast as well. Next one, I actually haven't played any of the other ones. I've only played those three, really. Oh, shit. I wasn't paying attention. Fuck. I just wasted, what, three or four? Adventurer, let's read him. Clear the bronze, cursed hallows to unlock this character. How long have you even unlocked him? When I get my phone, my new one, I'm definitely going to complete this game. I might record it as well, actually, because I haven't seen much gameplay of it. Gameplay footage of it. The next one is Spell Sword. So we have Adventurer. I see his little icon has a big sword. The Adventurer has scrolls. So I imagine he's a magic man of some sort. And finally we have a cultist, kind of an alien monster type woman, who I assume summons things. Judging by the little kind of fireball that she's got behind her and a weird kind of curvy dagger she's got in her hand. Oh, I wasted it again. I wasted a whole load of recovers, how dare I? Oh, the music is really nice in this as well. I recommend checking it out. It is nice. Tap screen to start. Extras. Oh, they've got hats. Yeah, they've got hats. It's kind of like a joke thing. You get them random drops. You don't need to use them. But, you know, the option's there for people who like that kind of crap. The controls are kind of nice. You can turn the story off as well. So after you've played through a dungeon once, it will stop showing you the story elements. And the story elements are such that you can just keep tapping and spam through it anyway, so you don't have to watch it. Which is always nice. What else can we do? What else can I talk about this thing without actually having played it? Because the bad thing about it is it doesn't have cloud storage or cloud saves. So I have it on my phone. On my phone, I've completed the first dungeon. I bought this years and years ago. Holy crap! I still had my HTC back then. I'm also keeping an eye on the time, so I need to finish in 10 minutes. So I'll finish doing what I'm doing now. Return to the pier, and that will be that for this session. Yeah, I've completed the first dungeon on my phone, but on my tablet. I installed it. I was planning on using my controller for it, my Bluetooth one. But the Bluetooth controls not very good, as it turns out. They're not really customizable, and they're not that intuitive the way they've done it. So there's also that to bear in mind. There's an intro kind of tutorial thing. It's really easy, really quick. As in, it's not. You can buy the soundtrack as well. Does it have achievements? Oh, install Google Play Games app. I do that. And they're on Facebook. Let's see what their Facebook page says. Rocket Cat Games. I thought it was Noodle Cake. Or something. It doesn't matter. Yeah, I recommend it. It's nice. That said, I've never completed it. Yeah. So, there's that. Hang on, I'm just going to grab my laptop and figure out if I need to go to work early today or not. I'd rather stay here and talk to myself. Let's have a look. Some password. Tablet's fallen over. Yeah, the battery in this tablet is definitely gone. It needs to be replaced. Okay, let's look at my calendar, not numbers. Quit. Let's do week. 13:30, yeah. So I need to be out of the house by 1:15, let's say. 1:15. Yeah, I ought to finish soon. Oops, I forgot to do my thing. Looking at the laptop. Yeah, I'm only going to have time to finish this off and then head off rather. I've got, this has been a really good haul, to be fair. even with my get info. Why does this work? Okay. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I don't really want to go work today. I said my work is really easy. What? Nah, just the kids have so much energy. It's really draining. Oh, I did it again. I wasn't paying attention. Three, two, eight, eight. So basically three, three. I'm not gonna lie, apart from emulators and that one game that I've just spoken about, I find mobile games to be really, really, really crap. I mean, really bad. I understand that they're mostly designed for kids because, well, in my experience as well, kids like really dumb shit. Sorry for swearing, but they really do. They really like stuff that isn't that good. And something I find just makes my skin crawl is top grossing. Clash Royale, Guns of Glory, Slots, Huge Casino, Lords Mobile, War Kingdom, King of Avalon, Rise of the Kings, Clash of Kings, Gardenscapes. All these games, I mean, I gave that Mobile Strike thing a chance, you know, when that was advertised by Arnold Schwarzenegger. I installed it on my phone and I went through it. And that game is all about just, look, click here. And I went through like a 20-minute tutorial, it seemed. Probably was only 5 minutes, but it felt like a 20-minute tutorial. And the tutorial was just like, oh, look, click here. It doesn't tell you why to click here. Just click it. Oh, crap, I did a blast. Just click here, trust me. Trust me, just click here. And then the next one, click here, now click here. And then click here, click here. Look, build yourself a barracks. Okay, click here, build a barracks. You've just depleted, you've just depleted your energy. Click here to buy more energy. Oh, it's really, really annoying. But that's the top grossing. That means it's the thing that they make most money from. And is it the case that it's, you know, they have a small player base, small sort of realistic player base, who are just, you know, thousands of pounds deep into that game? Or is it something else? I mean, after buying a game, how much, let me think, in terms of my own experience, Counter-Strike, I've played a lot of Counter-Strike, the new one. Back when I first bought it, I bought it for, what, £12? Maybe even less, because I bought it way back when. I bought it for £12, and in Counter-Strike you have skins, and you have skins for the weapons, there are like case drops, all this kind of nonsense. And right at the beginning, I made money off it, so I think I made a profit of around, if I calculate all the profits that I've made in my mind on that game, no, not profits, all the kind of money that I've got back from that game, it would equal around, let's say, let me think, I'll say around £40, maybe even £50. And this is just getting random drops from games or random cases, and cases can be sold because people like opening them and all this kind of nonsense. So I would have probably say I spent 12 on the actual game. I earned 50 in the cases, and I've probably spent around 10. I would have probably spent around 50 on just actual skins within the game. So I reckon I'm kind of even. It's as though I've only just bought the game once. Oh, sorry, it's only as if I've just bought the game, really. In terms of my sort of net profit or sort of net loss in the game. I just really don't understand the microtransactions thing. I remember I had a friend who had a much better PC than me back in the day. This was at the time when I was playing Delta Force a lot. And he had a much better PC than I had. And he encouraged me to get a game called Battlefield something something something. It was the free Battlefield. It was like the one that was released before Battlefield 3. And it was free to play, but obviously you had to, pay real money in order to get the good weapons. And on that, I think it was such that you paid a couple of pounds for in-game credits to be able to rent a weapon. So it's not as though that you unlocked this weapon that was yours for the rest of it. You rented it. Or was it the other way around that with in-game currency, you rent weapons, but with real money, you rent weapons for a lot longer, or you actually buy them outright? Obviously that game shut down after a while, so I would have been, if you spend loads of money on a game, yeah, well, and then it shuts down. Oh well. Okay, so I need to. I'm gonna start running it when I get down to 1,500, I think. 86 blasts, 104 freezes, and 45 twists. That is a lot of damage I've got stocked up, I think. Start running. Okay, that's plenty. Let's warp, save. I've got loads of spells now. What I need to do next is. Okay, healing, damaging. Okay, let me just put this down. Okay, I have. In this session, this was a kind of crap one, but. I have healing spells. I need more healing spells. I haven't done that, haven't done that, haven't done that. Okay. Right, well, that was session 12. Cheerio. Hang on, I'm just gonna save again. There we go. Cheerio.